Hello from the German capital city of Berlin. We are exactly in the city center at the famous Alexanderplatz and will travel today through the city, direction south, and then further on to Cottbus, discovering the A13 and A15 motorways, crossing a dense forested area in the German federal state of Brandenburg. So stay tuned for a very varied drive, first through the city of Berlin and then through the beautiful nature of Brandenburg. Berlin is the capital and largest city in Germany by both area and population, and with 3.7 million inhabitants, the most populous city in the European Union. Taking into consideration the population within the city limits, it is one of the 16 federal states of Germany, being situated in the northeast part of the country, surrounded by the state of Brandenburg on the river Spree, which flows into Havel in the west part of the city, in Spandau. The nature in Berlin is very beautiful, with many lakes and forests inside the city. First documented in the 13th century at the crossing of important trade routes, the city developed rapidly, being the capital of the Margraviate of Brandenburg, the Kingdom of Prussia, the German Empire, the Weimar Republic and the Third Reich. It has a very interesting recent history, as the city was divided after the Second World War. West Berlin became de facto an exclave of West Germany, surrounded by East German territory. East Berlin was declared capital of East Germany, and the Berlin Wall was built in 1961 around West Berlin to prevent people to leave East Germany through West Berlin, as this remains the only possibility to flee from the repressions of the communist regime in the East after the land border was closed at the beginning of the 50s. Following the German reunification in 1990, Berlin became the capital of the United country, and saw a lot of investments, being now a world city of culture, politics, media and science. The economy is based on high-tech firms and the service sector, with a broad range of creative industries, research facilities, media corporations and convention venues. Berlin is known as a very important startup hub in Europe. During the last 20 years, it became also an important tourist destination in Germany, as there are so many things to see and do here. The Zoological Garden is the most visited zoo in Europe and one of the most popular in the world. There are three UNESCO World Heritage sites, the Museum Island with many well-known museums like Pergamon, Bode or Humboldt Forum, built recently at the place of the former Berlin Palace. Among others, there are also some other museums beside Pergamon, Bode or Humboldt. The palaces and parks of Potsdam and Berlin and the Berlin modernist housing estates are also UNESCO World Heritage Sites. And other important landmarks include the Brandenburg Gate, a symbol of the city, the Reichstag building, where the parliament sits, the Potsdamer Platz, Berlin War Memorial, Berlin Cathedral, television tower at Alexanderplatz, to name just a few of the most important attractions. There are also numerous museums besides the ones from the Museum Island, like the German History Museum, the Story of Berlin, Topography of Terror, East Germany Museum, Stasi Museum, or the Jewish Museum. Despite being almost completely destroyed during the Second World War, some important buildings were rebuilt afterwards, like Charlottenburg Palace. Gendarmenmarkt is a very nice neoclassical square in the central part, with two similar cathedrals, the German and the French cathedral. Potsdamer Platz is entirely newly built after the wall came down, with modern buildings. The area around Hackescher Markt is home to fashion labels with many clothing outlets, clubs, bars and galleries. The Kurfürstendamm is home to some of Berlin's luxurious stores. At its eastern end, there is the Kaiser Wilhelm Memorial Church, destroyed during the Second World War and left in ruins. Nearby, there is a famous department store KaDeWe. In the east part of the city, the Karl Marx Allee is a heaven for the fans of the socialist classicism style, with many monumental residential buildings here. There is also a zoo and a big botanical garden called Gardens of the World in the former east part of the city. I tried to name just a few of the most interesting sites, but there are also many others in the city. Personally lived for 2 years in Berlin and had great time here, as the quality of life is very good too, and the city is very vibrant and young and dynamic. It must be a great place to study here, with many important universities, great nightlife and relatively cheap housing compared to other big cities in Germany. Near Berlin there is the city of Potsdam, the capital of Brandenburg, with its famous castles and parks. So like you see, one can easily spend 1 week here in Berlin and visit the city and the surroundings. From Berlin, after driving through the city direction south, we also drive near the Tempelhof Airport. We will be joining the city motorway A100 and then the A113, which will bring us out of the city, passing by the new Berlin Brandenburg Airport, finally opened after 8 years of delays. Soon after, we will reach the A10 motorway ring around Berlin, and from here the A113 becomes A13. A13 links Berlin with Dresden. It is 151 kilometers long and was built during the 30s, being already finished in 1940, with some sections built as half profile, expanded later to full profile until 1962. We are driving the A13 until the Spreewald motorway triangle, where we'll join the A15 to Cottbus and the German-Polish border. A15 is 64 kilometers long and was also built very early, during the 30s, as it was a connection between Berlin and the main city of Breslau, now Wroclaw, back then part of Germany. It was built as a half-profile motorway, being later expanded to full profile after 1990. The drive on the A13 and A15 is very pleasant, as we go through a mostly forested area. A great stop on the way is the Tropical Islands Spa Complex, built in a former Zeppelin test facility. There is a big swimming pool and many saunas there, very interesting. Personally been there once and had a great time. Another interesting stop on the way is the Spreewald, a large inland delta of the River Spree and a historical cultural landscape located in the region of Lower Lusatia, Lausitz in German. It is an extensive floodplain and a bog landscape designated as a biosphere reserve by UNESCO in 1991. And it is known for its traditional irrigation system consisting of more than 200 small canals for the unique flora and fauna and for its traditional flat-bottomed boats. Many of the inhabitants here are descendants of the first settlers, the Slavic tribes of the Serbs and the Vents. The Spree Forest is a tourist destination, many people exploring this area in ponds or by bike or foot. But now enough talking, and let's drive further on to Cottbus, and I'll be back near the city to say a few words about it. Until then, just sit back, relax, and enjoy the motorway drive through Berlin and Brandenburg.
dreams holding us closer. Meadows of our youth, 107 days, we're calling it backwards. Our dreams holding us closer.
hello once again. Hope you enjoy the drive from Berlin to Cottbus. We are now on the A15 motorway near Cottbus. The motorway functions as a south bypass of the city. We won't drive through it, but let's say a few words about Cottbus. It's an important city of about 100,000 inhabitants, the second largest in Brandenburg after Potsdam, and is considered the political and cultural center of the Sorbs, although only a small Sorbian minority still lives here. The settlement was established in the 10th century when the Sorbs erected a castle on a sandy island on the River Spree, and in the 13th century German settlers came here and lived side by side with the Sorbs. Cottbus developed a lot in the 19th century as industry appeared here in the area, and the city became also a railway junction. Textile industry was the main economical sector back then. Nowadays, Cottbus is interesting to visit with a pedestrianized area and many old buildings in the historical part. I visited it a few years ago as I was living in Berlin as a day trip from the capital. Many old buildings were renovated during the last 20 years, so it was a very nice stroll for a few hours through the central part. Shot also some pics, integrated them in the video at the end. And now I finished filming on the A15 immediately after Cottbus, as we were heading to Wroclaw. Stay tuned for this video too, and many others from our road trips here on the channel. And now let's see the photos from Cottbus, and I'm saying bye bye until the next.